Record. Okay. So again, this is the continuation of our discussion on Criminal Law Book 1. Of course, very important na malaman ninyo yung tinatawag natin. Wait lang pa sa. Okay. So thank you. So let's proceed now on our discussion. So again, it is the continuation. So from time to time, we asking questions sa ating, of course, sa ating comment box. So dapat i-maximize natin yan. So lahat ha, mag-participate. So we are now 25 ngayon kasi nga, of course, yung mga kasamahan ninyo or yung mga seniors ninyo na sa, ano lang, yung recordings ng sila nagde-reside. Okay, so dito yung exempting circumstances natin, class, sa continuation. Kasi nga, we already discussed yung different circumstances ng justifying. So now, of course, ang i-discuss natin is the exempting circumstances. So again, ulitin natin, as a review, pag sinabi natin exempting circumstance, it has an effect, means the person or the offender is free. Ibig sabihin, hindi siya makukulong. He is free or he is exempted with criminal liability but not with civil liability. So yan yung exempting circumstance. Again, ang exempting circumstance class, the person is not totally free kasi nga ano lang ang civil liability babayaran niya pa rin. Hindi rin siya makukulong. Of course, we have the different circumstances under the exempting circumstances. So ang tandaan niyo lang diyan, so we have the IMACO, okay? IMACO na acronym under the exempting circumstances. Yung letter I, of course, yung letter I, so that is imbecility or insanity. So you are imbecile, you are meron kang sakit sa utak or may problema sa pag-iisip, so that is imbecility or insanity. Once na commit ka class ng crime, you are exempted with criminal liability but not with civil liability. So halimbawa, of course, kapag may sakit sa utak class or may problema ka sa pag-iisip, it is given na hindi mo alam yung nature ng ginagawa mo, whether it is right or wrong. Then of course, hindi ka pagbigyan or hindi ka ikukulong ng state. Then but then again, babayaran ng parents mo whatever damages you incurred. So yan yung papasok sa imbecility or insanity. Then second, okay, so of course, 2 and 3 and class, nakalagay yung minority, okay, minority. So pag sabi natin minority, yung letter M, that stands for minority kasi isahin natin. So minority, of course, that is amended and suspended by Republic Act 9344. So kasi ngayon, di ba, dati, of course, under the revised penal code, ano lang siya, papasok sa exempting kapag you are a minor. But then again, totally free na ang tinatawag natin na minor once na commit sila ng crime. So it is amended and suspended by Republic Act 9344 o yung tinatawag natin na Juvenile Justice and Welfare Act of 2006. Okay, kung yung tinatawag rin natin na Minor Probation Law on the Philippines. Okay, yan yung 9344. Of course, yung letter A, that stands for accident. Okay, accident without fault of causing it. Okay, so yan yung tinatawag natin. Of course, pag sinabi natin accident, that is unforeseen or what we call unprecedented event. So yan yung papasok sa exempting circumstance. Then of course, fifth, the compulsion of irresistible force. So papasok yan class sa exempting circumstance. Then of course, we have the uncontrollable fear. Okay, so yan papasok yan sa exempting circumstance. But then all in all, so ang tanda nyo lang, ang tinatanong na naman mostly dyan pagdating sa criminal law is the definition or yung effect ng exempting circumstance. So basically, ang effect niya is to exempt the person from criminal liability but not with civil liability. So may babayaran pa rin siya ng danyos kung meron, of course, di ba, kapag ang person is criminally liable, he is also civilly liable. But then again, in exempting circumstance, he is only civilly liable. Okay, so yan yung exempting circumstance natin. Okay, dito naman tayo sa mitigating circumstances. Pag sinabi natin mitigating circumstance, it will meron siyang epekto class to reduce the penalty or ma-lessen yung penalty. from the maximum period, pwedeng mababa yan sa minimum period, or from 1 degree higher, imbababa yan sa 1 degree lower. So yan yung mitigating circumstance. Meron siyang epekto to decrease yung penalty provided by the law. Of course, magiging mitigating yan kapag yung tinatawag natin na incomplete justifying or incomplete exempting, ang tawag natin dyan, class, is a mitigating. So halimbawa, in the case of self-defense, kapag kulang kasi yung elements ng self-defense, hindi yan papasok sa justifying class. So kung nakalagay dyan, under the mitigating circumstances, magiging mitigating yung self-defense kapag, kaya nakalagay, incomplete justifying. So kapag kulang yung element, so magiging mitigating lang yan. Kapag hindi napatunayan na that person is acted in self-defense. So kapag incomplete yung whatever elements ng self-defense class or whatever elements ng particular crime, so under justifying and under exempting, papasok yan ngayon sa mitigating circumstance. Tandaan niyo, ha? Incomplete justifying or incomplete exempting circumstances, papasok yan sa mitigating. So it has an effect lang to decrease the penalty provided by the law. Okay? So yan yung mitigating circumstance. Okay. Then second, those person over 15 and under 18 or over 70 years old. So papasok yan sa mitigating circumstance. Over 15 and under 18, ibig sabihin, meron siyang ibababa lang, or over 70 years old. So tandaan nyo lang, young age and of course the old age, kasi kapag over 70 years old and above, that is already considered as an old age. So kapag nakagawa siya ng krimen, of course, hindi given na sa edad niya, i-release yan siya, class, early year based on the, hindi yun mafa-follow yung times and years na naka-prescribe sa kanyang, of course, kung ano yung binigay sa kanya ng punishment ng korte. So, over 70 years old, that is considered as an old age. Then we have the praetor intentionem. So we have the praetor intentionem. Okay, pag sinabi natin praetor intentionem, what is it? Ano ibig sabihin ng praetor intentionem, class? Okay, sige nga. So what is praetor intentionem? Actually, we already discussed it. So what is praetor intentionem? On the comment section, please. Ano ba talaga? Ay, ano ba ang ibig sabihin ng tinatawag natin na praetor intentionem? Praetor intentionem. Narinig niyo ba ako, class? Narinig ba? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sige nga. What is praetor intentionem?
Yung parang sinuntok mo, sir, tapos yung wala kang intention na patayin siya, pero namatay. Parang ganun siya.
Okay, so thank you. So, si Biscara, greater than that intended. Mm-hmm. So, of course, pag sinabi natin greater intention in class, of course, the result of the injury is greater from what is intended. Again, pag sinabi natin greater intentionem, ibig sabihin nun, the result of the injury is greater from what is intended. Halimbawa, gusto mo lang siya sampalin, pero nagkatawan na na-outbalance siya, nabugok yung ulo niya. So that is the greater intentionem. So papasok yan, class, sa mitigating circumstance. Kasi nga, but still, you are criminally liable. Ang intention mo or your purpose, of course, halimbawa, gusto mo lang disiplinahin siya, or gusto mo lang siya mabigyan ng parang warning signs. But then again, ang result is greater from what is intended. Gusto mo lang siya sapalin, but then again, namatay siya. So that is what we call under the greater intention. So fourth, there is a sufficient provocation. Okay, kapag nakita na you ikaw mismo ang nagsimula, or you just started the cruel, or yung tinatawag natin na gulo. So papasok yan sa mitigating circumstance. You cannot justify it. Hindi yan papasok sa justifying circumstance. Then we have vindication of grave offenses. Pag sinabi natin vindication, ibig sabihin, you justify that your action is reasonable, legal, and of course, right. So yan yung tinatawag natin na vindication of grave offense. Papasok yan sa mitigating class. Then number six, we have the passion or obfuscation. So passion, halimbawa yung mga crimes of passion natin. Okay, sige nga, magbigay kayo class ng mga sample or example ng mga crimes of passion. Okay, sige nga, kung na-remember ninyo yung mga na-discuss sa inyo. So what are the crimes of passion? Jealousy, celos. Okay, very good. So, ang mga crime of passion class, of course, because of extreme jealousy, extreme anger, and so on. So, papasok yan sa crime of passion. So, yun yung mga crimes of passion class. So, in the Philippines, very common yung tinatawag natin na, halimbawa, may girlfriend ka, tapos iba yung kinakasama niya, or my husband, your husband and wife, then iba rin yung kasama niya sa ibang bahay. So that's why kapag napatay niya, that is considered as a crime of passion or obfuscation because of the extreme heat, or because of the extreme what you call this, yung that at that moment. So kaya nakamit niya yung crime na yon. So that is sa passion of or obfuscation. So yan. Then seven, we have the voluntarily surrender, or when you voluntarily surrender to the authorities class, papasok yan sa mitigating circumstance. Again, kapag sarili mo mismo or ikaw mismo, hindi ka na pumunta or hindi ka na pumunta sa ibang lugar para magtago kapag nakakommit ka ng crime, so under the law, it will be considered, or ano na nila, siyempre, hindi mo na sila binigyan ng masyadong or yung tinatawag natin na time na hulihin ka or hanapin ka pa. So that's why it is considered as what we call mitigating. So medyo bababaan or bababa yung punishment na ibibigay sa iyo ng korte. So and there we have the voluntary surrender. Then when you have a physical defect, okay, so when you are a mute, kahit yung mga may kakulangan sa katawan mo, so papasok yan sa mitigating circumstance when you committed a crime. Then papasok rin sa mitigating circumstance when the person is, of course, may illness of the offender, lalo na yung mga medyo malala yung dinadamdam niya before siya ikulong. That's why it will be a mitigating circumstance yan, or before siya ipasok sa selda. So illness of the offender. So halimbawa, may heart failure siya, meron siyang tawag nito, yung medyo incurable disease. But so that's why it will be mitigating. But then again, it will be subjected to different procedures pa rin kung ihahalo class. Kapag, liba, kapag meron kang tawag nito, contagious disease, or yung pwedeng mamamana or pwedeng mo maipasa sa iba. So yun yung tinatawag natin na illness of the offender. Then 10, of course, we have the similar to the nature, so yung maganda nabanggit sa taas. Then of course, plea of guilty or voluntary confession of guilt, papasok yan ngayon sa tinatawag natin na mitigating circumstance. So yan yung mga privileges na binibigay ng batas natin, of course, yung pinakita natin or yung pinakita niya na instead na lumayo, okay, instead na magsinungaling pa, instead na i-google yung time sa, halimbawa, sa trial and hearing, so nagbigay na lang siya or he already plead guilty. to a lesser offense, okay, or lesser to a particular crime rather. Okay, so yan yung mitigating circumstance natin. Okay, nakuha ba? Nakuha ba, class, yung mitigating circumstance? Again, ang purpose niyan is to decrease or to reduce the penalty provided by the law. So, of course, yan yung mga different circumstances natin. So, again, ha, mamaya after ng mga discussion natin, so dapat isulat nyo. So, dapat ilagay nyo 11 mitigating circumstance. So, para mas maganda yan, class, ha, isa yung technique na yan na ilagay ninyo or lagyan ninyo ng pangalan or lagyan ng yung mga privilege mitigating and so on, class. Huwag nyo nang problemahin yon. Kasi nga, hindi naman sila pupunta doon at yun talaga yung itatanong nila. Again, ang board exam is basic. Okay, board exam is basic, class. Ang dapat yung malaman, yung pinaka-main or yung mga, ano ba, yung mitigating circumstances. Yung iba kasi, pupunta pa sa mga privilege mitigating and so on. Pero hindi yun sila magtatanong, class. Itatanong yan sa bar exam. Hindi naman kayo magbabar exam. Ang kailangan lang ng CLJ, class, or ang kailangan lang criminal law, yung pinaka-basic. Hindi yung pangana-master yung 11 mitigating circumstances. Of course, kailangan din niya yung mga privilege mitigating and so on. But then again, so dapat ito yung mga master niyo, class. Kasi di ba, pagdating niyo sa board exam, ang question na naman mga basic, pero hindi niyo nasasagot. Kasi nga, ang layo ng preparation niyo sa actual board exam. So as much as possible, palaging sinasabi namin sa crim coach for how many years already na focus on the basics, 'di ba? Para yung na-post ko, you cannot master what you don't understand. So okay lang naman 'yon, yung mga privilege mitigating, but then again, we will focus dito muna, class, sa pinaka-basic na ano na discussion. Kasi pagdating sa board exam, time consuming kapag mag-proceed pa tayo or pumunta pa tayo doon sa pinakamalayong details. Focus muna tayo dito sa ano, sa pinaka-basic. So ayan, so nakuha na ba? Nakuha na. So 30 na tayo. Okay, sige. Next tayo, next. Okay, so then natapos na natin, class, ang mitigating, so pupunta na tayo ngayon sa aggravating circumstances. Actually, ang daming aggravating circumstances, so 21 actually. But then again, yung 21 na yan, class, nahalo yan or nahati yan sa lima. Okay? So sa lima, of course, we have moplametetype. Okay? Moplametetype. Okay, so ayan yan. Yung mo, sorry, yung pla, me, yung TUI, and of course we have the PE. So again, so we have the aggravating circumstances mopla me TP or moplametetype. Okay, so yan yung mga acronym na ginagamit natin under the aggravating circumstances. Of course, nahati sila sa lima. So number one, we have the motivating power. Okay, so sa motivating power, of course, kapag in exchange of reward, in exchange of money, in exchange of promise, so papasok yan sa aggravating circumstance, class. Kapag nakapatay ka, okay, so in exchange of money, in exchange of reward, or in exchange of promise, tataas yung penalty na ibibigay sa iyo ng korte. Kasi papasok yan sa aggravating circumstance. Take note, magkaiba ang aggravating circumstance sa qualifying circumstances of murder. Ang qualifying circumstances, class, matatagpuan nyo lang yan sa crime na murder under Article 248 of the Revised Penal Code, yung anim na nabanggit doon. So, ano ba yung mga treachery and alibosya? While ang aggravating circumstances, class, of course, dito yan matatagpuan sa circumstances affecting the criminal liability of the offender. So dito sa book 1, yung GMA natin. So halimbawa, dito sa motivating power, pag sinabi natin motivating power, what is that cause or what is that yung pinaka-reason why you committed a crime? So halimbawa, in exchange of reward, in exchange of money, in exchange of promise, papasok yan ngayon sa motivating power. Then, of course, second, we have the place of the commission. Okay, so yung place of the commission, magdedetermine yan kung whether it is mitigating or aggravating. But then again, kapag dito sa aggravating, so halimbawa, uninhabited place. Kapag in uninhabited place, yung doon ka gumawa ng krimen. So pag sinabi natin uninhabited place, ibig sabihin, of course, walang nakatira doon. So kapag ginawa mo yung krimen doon, of course, it will be aggravating. So halimbawa, kasi gusto mo siyang gusto mo i-rape mo siya, gusto mo i-rape, then dinala mo sa abandonadong bahay or uninhabited place, so it will be taken as an aggravating circumstance. Then halimbawa sa palace, okay, doon ka gumawa ng krimen, doon sa palace natin, so or sa executive officer or executive department natin, so it will be taken as aggravating circumstance. Kasi nga, under the Constitution, it is parang disrespect to the authority of the President. So yan yung sa, and of course, marami pang example dyan. Dalawa lang yung nalagay ko. Then third, yung means and ways employed. Ibig sabihin, yung pamamaraan or yung tool na ginamit yung class before niya na-accomplish yung crime. Okay, so number one, of course, sa means and ways employed, yung treachery. Okay, pag sinabi natin treachery, that is, of course, or alibosya. So, yung pag-traidor. Of course, not at all, no? Pag-traidor. So, ibig sabihin na pag sinabi natin treachery class, hindi ka binigyan ng chance, okay, wala ka talagang chance at all to defend yourself or your yung sarili mo from the violence or from the attack. So, diyan yung under the treachery. So, halimbawa, yung sinaksakan niya patalikod or nakatulog ka, sinaksakan niya, then binaril kanya patalikod, papasok yan sa treachery. Ibig sabihin, kahit 1% chance, wala kang time or wala kang chance to defend yourself from the attack or from the danger. So papasok yan sa tinatawag natin na treachery. Then of course, another example is the evident premeditation. So pag sinabi natin evident premeditation, of course, maraming nagtatanong dyan. So what is evident premeditation? So tandaan niyo, pag sinabi natin evident premeditation, there is a careful planning ahead the commission of the crime. So papasok yan ngayon sa tinatawag natin na evident premeditation. So of course, mamaya explain natin what is that means. Of course, we have the time or the nocturnity na tinatawag natin. So wait lang plus. Okay, so we have the nocturnity. Okay, so halimbawa kapag gabi mo ginawa yung krimen, so papasok yan ngayon sa tinatawag natin na aggravating circumstance. Then of course, we have the personal circumstances. Kapag sa relationship yung tinatandaan natin. So of course, sa relationship, meron tayong kapag magiging aggravating yan, halimbawa sa crime of rape, kapag within your family yung gumawa, of course, it will be taken as aggravating circumstance. Okay? So again, we have the aggravating circumstances under the of course, yung GMA natin, yung qualifying or yung circumstances affecting the criminal liability of the offender. So again, so we have the five, of course, aggravating circumstances. But then again, we have 21 specific aggravating circumstances. So pag sinabi natin aggravating circumstances class, again, as a review, it will be taken into account, ibig sabihin, tataas or it will increase the penalty provided by the law. Pwede from minimum period, iakyat yan sa maximum period or from one degree, itataas yan yung one degree higher yung magiging punishment na ibibigay ng korte. Of course, para madali nyo matandaan, yung different circumstances na yon ihatiin natin sa lima or sa five na different factors. So ang tanda niyo diyan na acronym na ginagamit natin yung MOPLA ME type, okay? MOPLA ME type. Okay, yung MO that stands for motivating power. Okay, so sa motivating power, tandaan niyo na papasok 'yan sa motivating power kapag yung person or that particular person in exchange of reward, in exchange of money, or in exchange of promise, he committed a crime. So papasok yan sa aggravating circumstance. So second, of course, we have the place of the commission. So malaking factor yan na pwedeng papasok sa aggravating circumstance. Of course, halimbawa, sa place of the commission, so uninhabited place mo ginawa yung krimen or sa palace, okay, so under the office of the executive, then papasok yan sa aggravating. Third naman, sa means and ways employed, okay, whatever tool or pamamaraan na ginamit mo, halimbawa, yung treachery. So pag sinabi natin treachery, of course, or alevosya, wala kang chance at all to defend yourself from the attack. Okay, halimbawa, binaril ka patalikod or sinaksak ka patalikod, so that is treachery. So meaning, wala kang chance at all to defend yourself from the attack. Then pag sinabi natin evident premeditation, of course, ang evident premeditation, there is a careful planning ahead of committing a crime. Ibig sabihin, pinagplanuhan mo ng mabuti before ka, or halimbawa, before mo siya patayin, before mo siya saksakin. Meaning, alam mo, or i-prepare mo na kung ano yung gagamitin mo na tool, or yung baril ba, or knife. So, papasok yan sa evident premeditation. So, meaning, there is a careful planning ahead of committing a crime. So, that is evident premeditation. Papasok yan ngayon sa aggravating circumstance. Then of course, we have number four, we have the nocturnity. So of course, nocturnity is will be taken as aggravating circumstance. Then of course, on the personal circumstances or yung tinatawag natin na relationship. Okay, so kasi ang factor niyan is the relationship. Ano ba? In the crime of rape, kapag yung gumawa niyan sa'yo is within the member of your family, papasok yan as aggravating circumstance. Nakuha ba? Nakuha ba, class? Okay na? Okay na?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sige. Okay, paki-off lang ng microphone yung class. May bata kasi na ano. Narinig natin. Okay. So, next slide tayo. Okay, so dito tayo sa very important trend. Okay, so very important circumstance or circumstances affecting the criminal liability of the offender is yung tinatawag natin na alternative circumstances. So tandaan ninyo, under the alternative circumstances, papasok yan or yung acronym na ginagamit natin dyan is yung RID or R-I-D. So ano yung ibig sabihin ng RID? Of course, yung R that stands for relationship, yung I naman that stands for intoxication, and yung letter D that is the degree of instruction and education of the offender. So again, tandaan nyo lang kapag under the alternative circumstance, yung acronym or yung mnemonics na RID. Okay? So we have yung R that stands for relationship, yung I naman that stands for intoxication, and then yung D that is the degree of instruction and education of the offender. So tandaan niyo, under the GMA or under the circumstances affecting the criminal liability of the offender, ang tinatawag natin na alternative circumstance, it has an effect whether it is will be taken into account, whether it is aggravating, ibig sabihin tataas yung penalty, or mitigating, ibig sabihin, bababa yung penalty na binigay ng korte. So, of course, halimbawa, sa tinatawag natin na intoxication. So, in the crime or yung intoxication class, dalawa lang yung tanda niya dyan. Whether the person is an habitual drunker or not an habitual drunker. So, halimbawa, kapag he is an habitual drunker, okay, mahilig siya uminom or sanay na siya uminom, then related to that or in relation to that, nakagawa siya ng krimen, so it will be taken as aggravating circumstance under the eyes of the law. So kapag naman you are not an habitual drunker, ibig sabihin wala kang experience uminom o wala kang experience at all sa pag-inom, then nakagawa ka ng crime related to that, so that it will be taken as mitigating circumstance. Ibig sabihin, bababa yung penalty na binigay sa iyo. So under that intoxication. Then of course, we have the degree of instruction and education of the offender. So dalawa lang rin ang tinitingnan diyan, higher education, of course lower education. Kapag ginamit mo yung pinag-aralan mo or yung learnings mo, ano ba, yung degree mo to commit a crime, okay, para man loko or para man lamang ng kapwa mo, it will be taken as aggravating circumstance. Again, kapag you took advantage of your learnings, you took advantage of what you've learned, of your degree, then gumawa ka ng krimen, so it will be taken as aggravating circumstance. Then halimbawa naman, kapag wala kang pinag-aralan or wala talagang alam at all, then nakagawa ka ng krimen, so of course, fair naman yung ating batas, it will be taken as mitigating. Of course, hindi niyan magiging justifying, ah. Hindi rin yan magiging exempting. Mag-mitigate lang. So it has an effect to reduce your penalty. So again, of course, same instances, papasok sa relationship. Again, under the alternative circumstances, tandaan nyo lang yung RID. Relationship, intoxication, and degree of instruction and education of the offender. So, ayan. So, I hope it's clear sa inyo yung tinatawag natin na different circumstances affecting the criminal liability of the offender. Mm-hmm. So, ayan. So, natapos na natin yung tinatawag natin na circumstances. So, let's proceed now on the next slide. Okay. But then again, para pa natin kasama, matitingnan man natin or ulit. So again, so we have the juridical conditions of penalty. So again, so under the juridical conditions of penalty, so we have the triplek, okay, yung triplek, yung 3P, and of course yung L, E, C, 2. Ibig sabihin ng C2, dalawang C, okay? So we have the juridical conditions of penalty, so tandaan nyo lang yung triplek. So yung unang P, that is productive, so ibig sabihin that person is productive of suffering. Tinitingnan niya yan without affecting human integrity. So magbibigay ng penalty yung batas natin or magbibigay ng penalty ang state natin. But then again, hindi naman yung to the extent na ikakamatay niya na. That's why without affecting human integrity. Then of course, pag sinabi natin proportionate or commensurate, so yan ma-apply natin class yung just deserted theory. The punishment should fit the crime. Whatever crime you committed, see to it na ang punishment or yung severity ng punishment hanggang doon lang. So that is the proportionate or commensurate. Then of course, we have another P, personal. Pag sinabi natin personal, na no person shall be imprisoned for the crime committed by other person or for other people. So meaning, no proxy. Okay, so no person shall be punished for the crime committed by other person. Then of course, we have the legal. Okay, so sa legal naman, meaning ang crimes na na-commit niya crash is in accordance with law. Okay, so ang penalty na ibinigay ng batas is in accordance with law. Yung penalty na binigay sa tao na yon is in accordance with law. So halimbawa, yung crime na homicide, of course, that is in accordance with law, yung reclusion temporal na ibibigay sa kanya na penalty kasi yan yung itinalaga ng batas natin na magiging penalty niya. Then of course, we have equal or yung tinatawag natin na fair. Sir, ayan po ba ang determinate and indeterminate? Mamaya explain ko kung ano yung indeterminate and determinate. So then of course, we have equal class. Pag sinabi natin equal yung penalty, so of course, meron tayong tinatawag na fairness. Okay, you deserve what you committed. Okay, whatever penalty na binigay sa'yo, you deserve it. Okay, fairness. Kapag fair yung ating penalty, whatever your race, your religion, whatever your status in our community, so yun ang ibibigay sa iyo kasi nga may fairness yung ating batas when it comes sa penalty. And of course, we have the certain. Pag sinabi natin certain, ibig sabihin no one may escape from its effect, or no one may escape from the effect of the penalty. So kung ginawa mo yung krimen na yan, then kailangan mo yan pagbayaran, whatever crimes or whatever penalty na ibibigay sa'yo. Kaya certain, kapag gumawa ka ng krimen, no one may escape from its effect. Okay, so that is certain. Then, pag sinama naman natin correctional, okay, sa correctional naman class, ang purpose ng correctional is to reform an individual. But then again, ang penalty na ibibigay ng korte or bibigay ng state is not actually a punishment class. So it's actually, ang purpose niyan is to reform an individual. It is actually more on the treatment, okay? Ang purpose niyan is to reform an individual na i-prepare sila as they go back to the community kung saan sila nanggaling. So that is the juridical conditions of penalty. So may nagtanong dito si Ma'am Giselle, sir, ayan po ba yung determinate and indeterminate sentence? Okay, so tanganin nyo, pag sinabi natin determinate sentence class, ibig sabihin, there is a fixed punishment or penalty na binigay yung batas natin. So just like for example, sa crime or yung penalty na reclusion perpetua. So consider diyan as determinate sentence kasi nga naka-fixed yung penalty, which is 20 years plus 1 day to 40 years. So consider siya as determinate sentence. So basically, alam mo yung minimum, which is 20 years, medium 30 years, and maximum is 40 years. So yan yung tinatawag natin class na determinate sentence. Ibig sabihin, there is a fixed punishment or penalty na itinalaga or binigay yung batas natin. So that is determinate sentence. Pag sinabi naman natin indeterminate sentence, indeterminate, ibig sabihin indefinite. Okay, walang fixed punishment or penalty na binigay yung batas. Ang pinaka-best example for indeterminate sentence is what we call the life imprisonment. Again, life imprisonment. Kasi ang reclusion perpetua, of course, that is the highest penalty as of now under the revised penal code. Kapag na-violate mo is the revised penal code. Then kapag life imprisonment naman class, that is the highest penalty naman na binibigay kapag ang na-violate mo is the special penal laws or the special laws. Halimbawa yung mga Republic Acts and of course mga presidential decrees and so on. But then again, under the indeterminate sentence, you cannot predict what is the minimum, median, and maximum of your sentence kasi nga indeterminate or indefinite. There is no fixed punishment or penalty provided by the law. Again, determinate, ibig sabihin, there is a fixed punishment or penalty, while in the indeterminate sentence, there is no fixed punishment or penalty na binigay ng batas or yung state natin. Nakuha ba? Nakuha, class?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sige. Okay, so dito naman tayo kayo, class, sa tinatawag natin na theories of justifying penalty. Okay, so we have the theories class of justifying penalty na tinatawag natin. Okay, so ayan. So kapag may question kayo, class, huwag kayong mahiya mag-comment doon sa comment section natin. But of course, sasabihin ko yan kung may mga terms kasi or may mga topics na essential. Ibig sabihin, kailangan talaga ma-discuss yan. Kapag hindi naman, of course, kailangan natin i-filter yon. Okay, so baka, kasi ang iniiwasan natin, class, of course, nakafocus tayo sa quality. Okay, quality talaga, class. Hindi tayo, kaya that's why, di ba, yung students, ang tinuturo ka sa students, mostly, more on technique. Okay, more on technique, yung skills. Kasi pagdating sa board exam, kahit 100 pa yung speaker ninyong nagkakataon na hindi itatanong yung question or yung na-discuss ng speaker ninyo. But then again, kapag meron kayong technique, class, on how to answer question, on how to focus on the keywords and etc., it will be your advantage, class, in taking the board exam. Okay? So, ganun ang ano natin, ha? So, ganun ang mag-atake sa board exam. Do not focus or do not aim to get the correct answer. Ang dapat niyong malaman, dapat yung lesson na makuha ninyo out of this lecture natin. Every time na nagle-lecture ako, yung strategy yung dapat ninyo makuha. Okay, that's why kaya 'di ba yung mga presentation ko is hindi masyadong maraming maraming words kasi nga ang nilalagay ko diyan yung pinaka-appropriate or yung ginamit mismo ng batas. Hindi ako nagdadagdag, hindi rin ako nagbabawas. Kasi nga, yun yung tinatawag natin, of course, sa batas natin, class. Kasi very specific eh. Ang mga questions sa board exam is very specific. Meaning, halimbawa, minsan word by word pa nga yung kinag-question nila. That's why, dito dapat kayo mag-improve. Okay, so we have the theories class of justifying penalty. Of course, pag sinabi natin prevention, of course, to suppress danger. So, dito sa prevention class, habang hindi pa nangyayari, of course, sinasuppress na natin yung danger or whatever signs na may mangyaring krimen. So, that is prevention. While the self-defense naman, to protect the society. Of course, di ba, kapag self-defense, na-explain na natin, that is self-preservation. Of course, aside from that, kapag sa self-defense to protect the society, ikukulong natin yung individual or yung tao na yon para, of course, malayo sa gulo yung magiging kalabasan or malayo sa gulo yung ating community or yung society. So, yan yung tinatawag natin self-defense. Then, of course, sa reformation naman, to correct or to rehabilitate offenders. Then, of course, piniprepare natin sila class kapag babalik na sila sa mainstream society or sa mainstream community. Then, we have the exemplarity. Pag sinama ng exemplarity, it will serve or that person serves as an example to others. So, that is exemplarity. Then, halimbawa, yung may na meron ng nabitay or binitay under the death penalty, so, yung mga susunod o yung mga tao is mag-iisip muna kung gagawa sila ng krimen. Kasi nga, there is a harsh punishment given or provided by law. So, that is exemplarity. It will serve as an example. Then, of course, ang justice naman, it is an act of retributive justice. Okay? So, justice. Pag sa mga justice, of course, given or it is an act of giving what is due or what is right. So that is justice. Then, di ba, pag sinabi natin justice delayed is justice denied. So it is connected as well sa tinatawag natin na justice. Again, tandaan nyo lang, under the theories of justifying penalty, so we have prevention, ibig sabihin, to suppress danger. Pag self-defense naman, to protect the society. Ang reformation naman class, to correct or to rehabilitate offender. Under the exemplarity naman, it will serve as an example to people or to all na hindi nagagawa ng krimen next time. Okay, of course, kasi nga there is a laid down penalty na binigay ng batas. Then of course, justice, it is an act of retributive justice. Okay, inom muna ako ng tubig. Sige. Then, of course, let's proceed now on the next. Okay, so meron tayong dito class na classification of penalties. Okay, kasi hindi rin ito nadi-discuss sa iba. So, i-discuss natin class. Okay, please familiarize yourself with this. So, sa classification of penalties, so we have the based on severity or gravity of the penalties provided. Of course, under the based on severity or gravity, so we have the capital, afflictive, and correctional. So sa capital class, of course, that is the death. But then again, ang death ngayon is temporarily suspended sa Pilipinas. Then, of course, we have the afflictive. Under the afflictive, papasok yung tinatawag natin na reclusion perpetua, reclusion temporal. Of course, we have the temporary perpetual absolute disqualification, temporary special absolute disqualification, and of course, the prison mayor. Then, under the correctional naman class, of course, we have the prison correctional, destierro, arresto mayor, and of course, we have the suspension. Under the light punishment naman class or classification of penalties, so we have the arresto minor, and of course, the public censure. Then of course number 5 yung mga penalties common to the three preceding classes Of course, nandyan yung fine and of course yung ban to keep the peace. So yan kasi ang classification of penalties. Tandaan niyo, kapag tinanong class is the classification of penalties based on severity or gravity. Ang isasagot nyo dyan, pwedeng capital, afflictive, correctional, it is light, and so on. Kasi iba-iba yung tinatawag natin na classification of penalties, yung PT McCord AMA-AMI, sa tinatawag natin na classification of penalties class based on severity or gravity. Kapag tinanong based on severity or gravity, ang isasagot nyo dyan, whether it is capital, whether it is afflictive, whether it is correctional, whether it is light, and of course, yung mga penalties common to the three different preceding penalties or classes of penalties na doon sa taas natin. Okay. Okay, so magkaiba naman class yung tinatawag natin na based on their nature. Okay, so...
Sir, pwede pa kayo balik sa screenshot ko lang?
Sige. Sige, screenshot nyo muna class. Sige. Okay, so isulat nyo mamaya, isulat nyo mamaya pagdating or after ng ating discussion dito. Okay, so screenshot nyo class para ano. Okay, so yan na ang classification of penalties. Kasi dapat wala tayong maiwan dito. Ha? Wala bang record ang Zoom natin? Di ba na recording to class? Recorded naman, di ba? Yes, recorded. Yes, recorded po. Baka kakapasok lang ni ma'am. Okay. Sir, wala pong record itong Zoom natin. Hindi, naka-record po siya. Mm-hmm. So, ayan. So, nabahala rin ako. Akala ko wala. Okay, so ayan. So, yan yung classification of penalties. Don't worry, class. I remind you kapag mawala yung recording natin kasi yun yung iniingatan natin or yun yung tinatingnan palagi natin na dapat ma-record talaga para may balikan kayo. Then, of course, we have the based on their nature class. So, we have the principal penalties and of course, we have the accessory penalties. Under the principal penalties class, so meron tayong tinatawag na divisible and indivisible. Of course, ang divisible pwedeng mahati yan into three periods na tinatawag natin. So we have the three periods of penalty. So we have the minimum, medium, and maximum. So tandaan niyo class, under the principal penalties, meron tayong tinatawag na divisible. Ang divisible penalties, that is divided into three periods, whether it is minimum, whether it is medium, and whether it is a maximum period. Then ang indivisible naman class, ibig sabihin naka-fixed na 'yan. Okay, naka-fixed. No fixed duration of penalty. So halimbawa, yung death, yung life imprisonment, okay, yung perpetual absolute special disqualification, and of course, we have the PC or prison correctional. So yun yung mga indivisible penalty. So halimbawa class, kapag tinanong, it is the classification of penalty which has, okay, ibig sabihin, ano na lang, ganito. It is a classification of penalty which is divided into three different periods. Of course, ang sagot nyo dyan, divisible. Kapag tinanong naman, halimbawa, ang gagamitin niya or atakihin niya naman yung exemption to the rule or exemption to the given choices. The following are principal penalties under indivisible which has no fixed duration of penalties except, okay, so kapag binanggit niya doon ng death, life imprisonment, perpetual absolute special disqualification, and prison correctional, ang hindi nabanggit doon class, of course, yan yung hindi sagot. Okay, so of course, dapat na-familiar yung sarili niyo dyan kasi it's very important yan. Then of course, we have the accessories penalty or accessory penalty. It is deemed included in the principal penalties or penalties in kasa. So halimbawa, yung disqualification of office or civil interdiction. So halimbawa, disqualification of office class, the right to vote and be voted for in the public office. Ibig sabihin, nawala yung right to suffrage na iboto ka at then of course mag-serve ka as a government servant or public servant. Then of course, ang civil interdiction, nawala yung rights mo na to manage your property, to manage your family, and so on. So yun yung mga accessories penalties natin class. Tandaan nyo class, kapag sa accessories penalties class, Once nabigyan yan siya ng principal penalties or yung tinatawag natin na principal penalties, automatic kakibat or kalakip na rin yon yung tinatawag natin na accessory penalty. Parang pagtitingnan natin, kapag when a person, general rule, when a person is criminally liable, he is also civilly liable. So ganoon na lang dito. Kapag meron binigay or yung binigay yung principal penalties, automatic yan yung or kalakip yung tinatawag natin na accessory penalties as provided by law. Of course, magmamatter yan kung ano yung ibibigay ng batas natin. So accessory penalties ang tawag natin. Okay. So screenshot yung class para mabalikan yung mamaya. Okay, sabihan niyo ako kapag okay na. Okay, sige. Okay, next slide. Okay, so dito naman tayo ngayon class sa based on subject matter. Okay, so magkaiba yan class ha. So sa subject matter, of course, sa corporal punishment or the corporal penalty, of course, yun yung tinatawag natin na death. Okay, but of course, as of now, ang death is temporarily suspended. But then again, sa court class, sasabihin pa rin, punishable by death. So automatic, it is presumed or it is known na ang ibibigay sa kanya is the reclusion perpetua. Okay, so yan yung tinatawag natin na sa death. Okay, then second, we have the deprivation of freedom. So nandiyan yung reclusion perpetua, temporal, prison correctional, ame. Okay, arresto mayor and arresto minor. So of course, ikukulong ka class. Okay, so that's why deprivation of freedom. Kaya ang tawag sa'yo is PDL or the persons deprived of liberty. So under the deprivation of freedom. Third, we have the restriction of freedom. Of course, yung when you restrict, yung letter D class. Okay, kapag binigyan ka ng restriction of freedom, so ano yung ibig sabihin ng letter D na yan? So ano yung best example for restriction of freedom? What is letter D? Okay, so alam nyo to. What is letter D class under the restriction of freedom? Okay, very good. That is destiero. Okay, so destiero yan class. Kapag restriction of freedom, within 25 kilometer radius na pinangyarihan ng krimen, kasi di ba ang destiero binibigay yan class kapag that is an automatic penalty na binigay kapag yung husband is convicted by the court of a crime of concubinage. Automatic sa concubine or sa kabit niya, ibibigay yung crime or yung tinatawag natin na penalty na destiero. Then halimbawa, kapag napatay mo yung wife mo or yung husband mo kapag nakita or caught in the act, okay, under the exceptional circumstances, then papasok yung destiero. Actually, ang destiero class, hindi yan siya penalty. So it is actually parang ano lang yan. So para mag slow down yung pangyayari, okay, kasi di ba destiero, so actually hindi talaga yan sa penalty. So of course may explain ko yan on our criminal procedure kasi nakalagay yan doon. Okay, best ano yung dati. Then of course we have the pecuniary. Of course papasok yan sa fines. So again class, sa corporal punishment based on subject matter, yan yung death. Sa deprivation of freedom naman, reclusion perpetua, reclusion temporal, yung PC naman, prison correctional, yung AMA, arresto mayor, and yung AMI naman, that is arresto minor. Then sa restriction of freedom, the best classical example for that is destiero. Then under the deprivation of rights class, disqualification and suspension, you are disqualified to run for public office, you are disqualified to be elected in the public office, so papasok yan sa deprivation of rights. Then, of course, suspension. Then, kapag sa pecuniary naman, papasok yung tinatawag natin na fines. Magbabayad ka ng mga danios. Then, we have the Republic Act 93, 9346 class. It is an act prohibiting the imposition of the death penalty in the Philippines. Of course, kasi nga di ba, wala tayong death penalty in the Philippines ngayon. So, a person convicted of offenses punishable with reclusion perpetua or host sentences will be reduced to reclusion, of course, reclusion perpetua by reason of this act, shall not be eligible for parole under Act Number 4103 o yung tinatawag natin na ISL or the Indeterminate Sentence Law. Again, class, ha? Ang Republic Act 9346 class, yan yung nag-prohibit ng imposition of the death penalty in the Philippines. So yung persons convicted of death, of course, yung mga offenses punishable by death, automatic the sentence will be reduced to reclusion perpetua, but that person is not eligible or not allowed to avail yung parole under the Act Number 4103 or the Indeterminate Sentence Law or yung tinatawag rin natin class na parole law. Nakuha ba? Nakuha class? So paki-screenshot niyo class yung penalties based on their on the subject matter. Then sabihan niyo ako kapag okay na. Okay, sige. Okay, sige. Next slide. Okay, so dito naman tayo ngayon class or i-discuss naman natin ngayon yung tinatawag natin na fines. Okay, so we have the fines class na tinatawag natin. So we have the afflictive, correctional, and of course the life penalty. So kapag sinabi natin afflictive penalties class, kapag more than 6,000 pesos, papasok niyan ngayon sa afflictive penalties. Kapag correctional penalties naman class, ang pag-uusapan natin, 2,000 to 6,000 pesos. Then ang light penalty naman, less than 2,000 pesos, papasok yan ngayon sa light penalty. Again, ang afflictive, over 6,000, correctional naman, 2,000 to 6,000, and then we have the light penalty that is less than 2,000 pesos. So yan yung mga fines natin. Okay? So, yan. Then, okay, dito tayo class. I-explain ko what is the nature of destiero. So, of course, ang destiero class, yung ano yan, or under the exceptional circumstances, yung tinatawag natin na death under exceptional circumstances, yung pinatay mo, yung misis mo, or yung husband mo, kapag na-caught in the act mo sila na nagtatalik ng kanilang kabit. So that is under destiero, ibibigay yan ang penalty ng batas natin. So second, in case of failure to give bond for good behavior. Third, as a penalty for concubine. Tandaan nyo, as a penalty for concubine in the case of concubinage. And fourth, in cases where after reducing the penalty by one more degrees, destiero is the proper penalty. So again, yan yung tinatawag natin na nature of destiero. Okay, paki-screenshot niyo muna to class. Okay, okay na ba?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sige. Next tayo. Okay, so we have the preventive imprisonment, and of course, we have the civil interdiction. So parang palagi nila tanatanong ano yung pag sinabi natin preventive imprisonment. Okay, so ayan. So tanda ninyo ang pag... Okay, pag sinabi natin preventive imprisonment. So okay, so hindi ba maingay class ang ano? Okay lang ba yung boses ko? Sabihan niyo ako kapag maingay. Okay lang? Okay lang ba?
Okay lang po, sir. Okay lang po.
Ay, okay lang. Sige. Akala ko maingay. Okay, sige. So, ayan. So, we have the preventive imprisonment. So, palaging nagkakamali dito or maraming nagkakamali dito, ano ba yung ibig sabihin ng preventive imprisonment? So, ang preventive imprisonment class, that is the period of detention undergone or undergone by the accused where the crime which he is in charge or he is charged with is non-bailable. So, papasok yan ngayon sa preventive imprisonment. Pag sinabi natin preventive imprisonment class, so yan yung tinatawag natin. It is yung crime or yung days or yung times na ipamalagi niya class sa kulungan habang dinidinig o yung tinatawag natin na yung kaso niya is under trial and hearing pa or under investigation pa. Kapag he is convicted or he is convicted beyond reasonable doubt of that crime, yung crimes or yung days na pinamalagi niya doon sa loob ng kulungan, ibabawas yan class doon sa days niya na ikukulong or doon niya imamalagi or papo. Ayan, nahihirapan ako mag-Tagalog. So, i-English na lang natin. Okay, so ulitin ko. Pag sinabi natin preventive imprisonment class, yan yung mga days or times na the accused will undergone. Okay, so yung na-undergo niya, about 30 days na siya nakulong or 60 days na siya nakulong. Of course, ikukulong siya class. Kasi nga, yung crime na nakomit niya is non-bailable. Of course, he is not allowed to post bail. Okay, for his temporary liberty. So that's why wala siyang choice kung hindi siya makalabas doon sa loob habang yung kaso niya is on trial and hearing pa. Kapag in case class, okay, kapag in case na that person is already convicted, ibig sabihin napatawa na, na nagkasala ka talaga. Okay, so you are convicted beyond reasonable doubt of particular crime. Then yung times or yung days na nasa loob niya or yung binugol niya sa loob habang dinidinig yung kaso niya, i-divide yung class or i-deduct yung class or ibabawas doon sa days niya na lang na ipamamalagi niya sa loob ng kulungan. Halimbawa, ano lang naman, so ibig sabihin, mapa-early yung pagpalabas sa kanya. Then even if bailable, he is unable to post the requisite bail. But of course, ang pinaka-purpose ng class, he will be deducted or it will be deducted from the term of imprisonment. Yun naman yung maganda doon. So, konti na lang yung ipamalagi mo doon sa kulungan kasi nga na-serve mo na during kasi nagkaroon ka ng preventive imprisonment. But then again, class, ang preventive imprisonment, it does not apply to all. Apply lang yan kapag yung kaso mo is non-bailable offense or non-bailable crime. Okay, so yan yung preventive imprisonment. Then we have the civil interdiction. Ang civil interdiction class, of course, mawawala yan yung tanatawag na rin yung rights mo to parental authority or guardianship. Okay, kapag ano ba, nakulong ka or kalakip ng penalty na binigay sa iyo ng korte is yung civil interdiction. Ibig sabihin, wala kang karapatan class, okay, yung tanatawag na rin na parental authority or guardianship. Okay, mawawala yan sa iyo. Hindi mo na pwedeng tawag nito. Yung as a parent, so mawawala yan sa iyo. Parental authority or guardianship as a guardian. Then of course marital authority. Okay, sa marital authority naman of course, wala ka ng karapatan sa misis mo or sa tinatawag natin ng husband mo kasi nga that is marital authority. Civil interdiction. Then of course, mawala rin yung right mo class to manage your property and of course yung right mo to dispose such property. Wala ka ng karapatan to manage your property, yung ari-arian mo. Then hindi mo pwedeng ibenta yan or hindi mo pwedeng isangla yung property mo yan. Kasi under the law, yan yung binigay or yan yung kalakip na accessory penalty na binigay sa iyo ng batas natin. So again, ang preventive imprisonment, yan yung days na ipamamalagi ng accused doon sa kulungan kung saan yung penalty niya or yung kaniyang crime na nakumit is under trial and hearing pa. So but ang preventive imprisonment, it is only applicable to non-bailable offenses. So the days na ano niya doon na pamalagi sa loob, it will be deducted from the term of imprisonment provided by the law. Ang civil interdiction naman, mawawalan ka ng karapatan to manage your property and the right to dispose your property. Pero mawawala rin yung right to authority or marital authority rather. Then of course, we have the marital or yung rights of parental authority or guardianship. Nakuha ba? Yan yung tinatawag natin na preventive imprisonment and civil interdiction. Okay, good. Yeah. So, naturo ba to sa inyo class yung civil interdiction and so on? Or during ano ninyo, or during review or sa ano? Natuturo ba? Okay. Wala, patay talaga, no? So, ito kasi yung mga basic class na posible talaga na okay, yung preventive imprisonment lang alam ko dyan, coach. Ayan. O yan. So, yun yung danger na nakakalimutan yung pinaka-basic class sa board exam. Kaya, akala yung students, parang delikado talaga, di ba? Kung titingnan ninyo, 30% lang yung buwapasa sa board exam. So, saan naman yung ano, 70? So, meaning, may problema talaga class sa information, may problema talaga sa mga information na nakikita nila sa social media and so on na pinifeed sa utak nila. Okay? So, mabuti meron akong platform, of course, di ba? Parang sa feeling ko, hanggang ngayon, ang dami pa rin mga ilang message, mga 500 messages yung hindi ko open. Parang yung pumasa, parang naging student ko na rin sila, di ba? Online. Kasi nakuha nila yung mga strategy sa akin, yung mga techniques. Kaya, di ba? Mga third take na, five take, okay, sa akin pumasa. Then, of course, sa mga video ko lang yun, class, ha? How much more sa inyo na student ko kayo dito sa review? Okay. So, wait lang. Mainom muna akong tubig. Okay. So, dito class, pag-uusapan natin yung complex crime. Okay? Pag sinabi natin complex crime class, dalawa yan class. We have the what we call the compound crime or yung tinatawag natin na delito compuesto. Then second naman, we have the complex crime proper or yung tinatawag natin na delito complejo. Again, we have the two types or the two kinds of complex crime. So, we have the compound crime or delito compuesto. And then we have the complex crime or the delito complejo. So, tandaan ninyo, pag sinabi natin compound crime or delito compuesto, when a single act constitutes two or more or less grave felonies. Ulitin natin. When a single act constitutes two or more grave or less grave felonies. Okay. So, magbigay nga kayo class ng example ng delito compuesto or compound crime sa comment section natin. Titingnan ko kung tama yung mga sagot ninyo. Okay, bombing. Nagtapo ng granada, sir. Okay, ano pa? Ano pa, class? Arson. Ha? Hindi naman narinig. Arson. Okay, how about, ano pa? Nilagyan ng lason yung water system, sir. Okay, pwede ba yun? Nilagyan ng lason ng water system. Okay. So, hindi kayo familiar. Yung mga ano talaga class, magbigay yung mga, yung nakikita nyo talaga sa palagi sa choices, or nakikita nyo talaga sa gumawa ng virus, sir. Patay. Bakit umabot pa sa virus? Okay, bakit umabot sa virus? Ano? Rape with homicide. Okay? Rape with homicide. Yung binigay ni Ma'am Giselle, hindi ba siya pwedeng papasok sa complex crime proper? So mamaya, titingnan natin kung pwedeng papasok. Okay, so ganito class, oh, ganito. Focus kayo dito. Kasi very basic lang yan class, pero hindi yan nasasabi or na-explain ng maayos. Okay. Nawala. Okay, nawawala ang talk ninyo. Sige, ah, dapat pag-participate kayo. Okay. So of course, mamaya mag-iisip kayo. So, pag sinabi natin compound crime or delito compuesto class, tandaan nyo lang, when a single act constitutes two or more grave or less grave felonies. Okay, so halimbawa, okay, namaril ka class. Okay, namaril ka, may namatay. Okay, so that is grave. Then, may na-injured na dalawa or tatlo. So that's why, okay, meron yung crime na nakomit mo. Of course, homicide with okay multiple physical injuries, okay, di ba? Papasok yan sa tinatawag natin na compound crime or yung tinatawag natin na delito compuesto. Magkaiba yung aberratio ictus kasi ha? Ang aberratio ictus, that is mistake in the blow, di ba? Mistake in the blow yon. Ang compound crime class, ang pag-uusapan natin, papasok yan sa complex crime proper. Yung binigay ko kanina, okay? When a single act, okay, yung pamamaril mo class, okay, binaril mo siya, okay? Binaril mo yung si Mr. A, okay, namatay si Mr. A, tapos tumama rin yung bala, lumusot yung bala kay Mr. B, okay? Si Mr. B, hindi namatay, okay? Naano lang siya, na-injured lang siya class, nabuhay siya. Ibig sabihin, your act or yung single act mo class, it constitutes two or more grave or less grave felonies. So meaning, yung namatay is grave. Okay? That is homicide. Yung hindi namatay, pwedeng physical injuries. So yan yung ibig sabihin natin class ng compound crime or delito compuesto. Yung sa Twin Towers or yung hijacking po, compound crime din po ba yun? Okay, yung hijacking, yes, of course, ano yan, papasok yan sa tinatawag natin na compound crime. Diba? Tama naman yung mga binigay ninyo kanina na bombing. Okay, diba? May namatay. Diba? Sinabugan mo ng ito, ng ano yon, ng bomba yung isang lugar. May namatay na 10, may na injured, hindi namatay, naputulan ng paa, naputulan ng ano, physical injuries and so on. So papasok yan sa compound crime or delito compuesto. Nakuha niyo? Nakuha, class? Nakuha ba?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sige, next. Dito naman tayo sa second class. Okay, magtatanong ako ha, so para may participation kayo. Okay, dito naman tayo sa complex crime proper or delito complejo. Okay, so dito sa complex crime proper class or delito complejo, when an offense is a necessary means of committing the other. Ibig sabihin, class, mangyayari muna yung isang crime before, of course, connected ito sa naunang krimen. Again, ang pangalawang krimen na nangyari or nagawa, connected ito sa nangyari or naunang krimen. So ano yun? Sige nga. Okay, so magbigay kayo ng example class. Under sa complex crime proper or delito complejo. Okay, lahat, yung 30 participant, estafa. Hindi, dapat dalawang crime class kasi sinabi niya, an act or an offense is a necessary means of committing the other. So meaning dalawa yung nangyari or dalawa yung crime. Dapat connected, ha? Okay, so lahat mag-participate. Okay, sige. Okay, saan yung iba? 12 pa lang ang ano class, ang sumagot. Okay, see ya. Arson with homicide. Okay, sige. I-discuss natin to class and after that mag-break tayo or kumain muna kayo ng 30 minutes then babalik tayo kasi patapos na naman yung book 1 eh. Okay, so may nakikita ako dito ng mga sagot niyo na tama naman. Okay, so we have okay, sana yung isa kanina. So yung estafa. Okay? So ang best example niyan class, halimbawa yung estafa with falsification of documents. Ibig sabihin, nangyari muna yung estafa. Then, of course, yung falsification of document, of document rather, connected yan sa crime na estafa. So, estafa with falsification of documents. So, papasok yan sa complex crime proper or delito complejo kasi an offense is a necessary means of committing the other. So that's why it is a complex crime proper or what we call the delito complejo. So meron dito robbery with homicide. Ibig sabihin, on the occasion of robbery, okay, nung nagnanakaw siya sa loob, dumating yung may-ari, napatay niya. Pati yung may-ari. So that's why it is a robbery with homicide. Hindi sana mangyayari yung crime na homicide kapag hindi siya dumating, di ba? So, ibig sabihin, an offense, yung crime na robbery, it is a necessary means of committing a crime na homicide. So, that's why it is considered class as a complex crime proper or delito complejo. So, ayan. So, yun yung mga, of course, sabi niya, robbery with rape. Okay, so robbery with rape. Okay, so on the occasion of robbery, okay, pwedeng ganon, or pwedeng robbery with homicide. Okay, so on the occasion of the robbery, napatay niya. Then, ano pa ba? Another example for that is, okay, so yun class. So mga robbery with rape, robbery with homicide, falsification of documents, and so on. So, meaning, yung tinatawag natin, arson with homicide. Hindi mo pwedeng maggamitin class ang with sa arson with homicide class kasi ang arson is under the special law, then ang homicide naman is under the revised penal code. Okay. So, ganito class ha. Yung pinaka-ano natin dyan or yung general rule natin sa paggamit ng and with, gagamitin mo class yung with kapag yung pinagmulan ng crime na yan o yung law na yan isa-isa. Halimbawa, robbery with homicide. Okay, ang robbery at homicide, nanggaling yan sa what we call revised penal code. Kaya ginamit mo yung with. Or homicide and... Sorry. So, Okay, so again, ulitin ko, gagamitin mo lang yung term na with kapag yung crime or yung law na pinagmulan niyan is based on same. Okay, same what we call sources. Kapag RPC plus RPC, with. Okay, kapag revised penal code plus special law, then ang gagamitin mo class is and. Kasi hindi mo silang pwedeng pagdugtungin. We have homicide and arson, or arson and homicide, arson and murder. But then again, class, that is a general rule. There is an exemption pa rin. Okay? Meron pa rin exemption na ano natin. Meron pa rin gumagamit ng weed. Okay? So, pero hindi lahat. So, pero ang pinaka-general rule, under the rules of court, yun yung tinitingnan natin. Gagamitin mo yung weed kapag same source of law or information. Then kapag hindi naman, gagamitin natin yung help. Okay? So, it's already, ano na pala? It's already 7. So, medyo napaganda yung discussion natin, no? 5 tayo kanina nag-start. So, di ba? So, retain lahat yung ano natin, yung mga discussion. So, nasa quality tayo, class. Okay? So, again, pag sinabi natin complex crimes, dalawa yan. So, we have the complex crime proper. And of course, the compound crime. So before tayo mag-end class, ha? Ay, before tayo kakain lang. Okay? Kasi mag-end tayo mga 8:30. So pag sinabi natin compound crime class, again, when a single act constitutes two or more grave or less grave felonies, pag sinabi naman natin complex crime proper or the delito complejo, when the offense is a necessary means of committing the other, ibig sabihin, mangyayari muna yung isang offense or crime before mangyari or mag-took place yung isa. So, yan yung two kinds of complex crimes na tinatawag natin. Nakuha ba? Okay, so I hope marami kayo nakuha ngayon, class. Mag-break muna tayo, ha. Kakain muna after 30 minutes. Babalik tayo para matapos na natin ang book 1 para makaproceed tayo sa ibang area. Okay, so okay lang ba? Okay lang? Okay, mag-break muna tayo. Okay, so let's proceed now sa pecuniary liabilities class under the revised penal code. Actually, yung mga succeeding slides na to, ito yung mga last discussion or topics na dapat ma-discuss talaga in book 1. Kasi palagi itong napapabayaan, no? Hindi na-discuss. So minsan, marami silang tanong dito. So we have the pecuniary liabilities under the civil or under the revised penal code natin. So we have the civil, and of course we have the number 2, we have the pecuniary liabilities. So under the civil class, of course, kapag you are civilly liable, you must pay the damages na na-incurred mo during the commission of the crime or whatever crime ang na-commit mo, class. So that is civil. So meron tayong tinatawag dito na reparation. Okay, so pag sinabi natin, i-close muna natin. So pag sinabi natin reparation, class, from the word itself, repair. Okay, so reparation of the damages. You must repay or reparation or restore the damage you caused. Kung ano yung nasira mo or na-destroy mo, class, out of the commission of that crime, so papasok yan sa reparation of the damages. Ang indemnification naman, you must indemnify the consequential damages. So meaning, yung tinatawag natin na bayaran mo. Okay? Indemnify. Halimbawa, yung ninakaw mo is laptop. So yung laptop na yan is nagkakahalaga ng 20,000 pesos. Then, of course, babayaran mo yan. Walang labis, walang kulang. Kasi nga, yan yung tinatawag natin na civil liability, indemnification, or the consequential damages. Then, of course, reparation, indemnification, and yung tinatawag natin na restitution. Ang restitution naman, ibig sabihin yan, of course, you must restore. Kung yung ninakaw mo is laptop, palitan mo. Ay, yung ninakaw mo ng laptop na yun, ibig sabihin, ibalik mo kung ano yung ninakaw mo. Okay? Kung nawala na class, binenta mo na, papasok yung indemnification. Okay, nakuha nyo, ulitin ko ha, ganito yan class. Ang kaibahan sa reparation, indemnification, and restitution. Ang reparation of the damage you caused. Okay, ibig sabihin, yun yung tinatawag natin na you must restore the damages kung nasira mo. Okay, you must repair. Nasira mo yung laptop. Laptop na lang, wag na tayong lalayo sa iba. Nasira mo yung laptop, okay? So meaning, ipapaayos mo yan. Okay, i-restore mo yan as part of civil liability. Kapag naman, nabenta mo na yan class, nabenta mo na yung laptop, of course, wala na tayong magagawa dyan. Kung ano yung cost ng laptop na yun or yung bagay na yun, yun yung babayad mo. Ano ba? 20,000 pesos yun. So that is indemnification of the consequential damages. Okay? And then, magiging restitution na siya class kapag nandyan pa yung laptop, pinapasauli sa'yo ng korte. So that is the restitution. You must restore whatever things or whatever articles na nakuha mo out of the commission of the crime. So that is indemnification. Nakuha ninyo? Nakuha ba class? Nasundan ninyo yung sinabi ko, yung reparation and indemnification and restitution. Nakuha ninyo? Nakuha ba? Bakit walang sumasagot? Kumakain
yes, sir.
Ba kayo? Akala ko na kumakain ba kayo? Then, okay, na-late na siguro yung ano ninyo. Okay. Then, of course, hindi lang dyan magsa-stop class yung mga pecuniary liabilities or mga civil liabilities. Kasi, of course, meron pa tayong pecuniary. Ibig sabihin, yung fines, magbabayad ka ng damages or yung fines na itinalaga or binigay ng korte or ng batas natin. So that is fine. Then of course, yung cost of the proceeding class. Babayaran mo yan under the pecuniary liabilities. Yung abogado na yung kalaban mo, kasi gumastos talaga sila. Kasi nga, di ba, isang pirma lang na abogado, patak na yan agad-agad. So that is cost of the proceeding. So kung gaano ka mahal yan, so lahat yan, ito total. Aside sa mga damages na incurred mo, i-compute pa yan lahat class yung cost of the proceeding from the start of the filing of the case until the disposition or yung tinatawag natin na nabigyan ng judgment ang kaso na yan. So, yan. So, hindi, ano talaga kas, costly talaga masyado ang pag-file ng kaso dito sa atin. Okay, the cost of the proceeding. Then we have the subsidiary penalty class. Ang subsidiary penalty class that is imposed only on the non-payment of fine and cannot be imposed on non-payment of the damages. Sorry. So ayan, non-payment of damages. Take note class, kasi pera kapag titingnan mo yung definition niya, hindi mo yan talaga agad-agad makuha kung ano ibig sabihin ng subsidiary penalty. So halimbawa class, magiging subsidiary penalty na yan, magiging subsidiary penalty yan class, kapag yung accused or the person convicted of a crime class cannot pay the damages or cannot pay the fine na binigay ng korte. So wala siyang chance or wala siyang choice rather, whether, okay, of course, ang kailangan niya na lang is mag-sustain na lang siya sa kulungan. Ibig sabihin, kailangan niya na lang yung, halimbawa, yung fines is 20,000 pesos. I-multiply or i-divide yan ngayon, class, kung magkano, okay, kung ano yung minimum wage. Okay, nakalagay dyan, oh, yung basis of the computation of subsidiary penalty. It is a rate of one day for each amount equivalent to the highest minimum wage rate prevailing in the Philippines at the time of the rendition of judgment of conviction by trial. So, halimbawa, class, ang fine niya is 20,000 pesos. Okay, 20,000 pesos ang binigay ng korte. 20,000 pesos. Then, yung sasahod, yung minimum wage or yung highest minimum wage prevailing in the Philippines, ilagay natin. Magkano ba yung ano natin? Yung minimum wage ngayon, class, yung pinakamataas na meron tayo sa Pilipinas. Yung mga ano lang ha, hindi yung mga nasa mga public. Magkano ba yung minimum wage? Yung halimbawa, nagtatrabaho sa mga malls and so on. Bakit may tumatawag ka? Okay, sige class, magkano ngayon? Magkano nga? Naputol tayo. 4,000 460. So halimbawa, 460, 368 ata sir minimum. O, nakadepende actually class kung saan kayo. Sa Manila, sa Luzon, Visayas, or Mindanao. So ipagpalagay natin yung highest minimum wage is 460 pesos. So meaning, yung 20,000 na binigay na fine ng korte as punishment niya, ibig sabihin, ang ipamalagi niya class sa kulungan is 43 days. Okay? Dito sa computation natin na 43 days yung ipamalagi niya sa kulungan. Pero class, applicable lang yung subsidiary penalty kapag yung the person or the person convicted of a crime is cannot walang kakayahan class to pay the damages or non-payment of the damages. Then of course kapag yung fine is only a penalty, when yung penalty is only a fine, then yung fine na yon kahit maliit lang yan, hindi niya talaga kaya magbayad, so wala siyang choice. So of course i-request niya na pwede ba ikulong niyo na lang ako kung then ano yan under the subsidiary penalty. So meaning, kung ano yung highest minimum wage na sahod na meron or prevailing in the Philippines at the time of the rendition of the penalty, so yun yung magiging penalty na ibibigay ng korte class. Okay? So yun yung respective days na ibibigay ng korte. Okay? Nakuha ninyo? So naintindihan nyo ba ang subsidiary penalty class? Naintindihan nyo ba? Please confirm. So para mas ano natin? Wait lang pa sa. Okay, so ayan. Mm-hmm. So bakit ang daming nagpapareserve ng class ay ng lecture, pero fully book na yung yung schedule. So wala na tayong magagawa. Okay, so ayan. Yes, okay, good. Okay, next. So we have the penalty to be imposed upon the principals in general. So meron tayong mga penalty imposed in different penalties in general. So of course, meron tayong number one class by degrees, number two naman by periods, and of course, ayan. So by degrees and by periods. So explain natin yan one by one para mabigyan kayo ng general view kung ano yung ibig sabihin ng mga penalties na yan. So pag sinabi natin by degrees class, so tandaan niyo kapag by degrees, of course we have one unit of penalties. So we have nahati yan sila sa dalawa, sa stages of execution and the degree of criminal participation of the offender. So under the stages of execution class, we have the three stages of execution. So we have the CAF, di ba, nung binigay ko na na acronym. So yung consummated, attempted, and frustrated. So meaning, kapag sinabi natin attempted, ano yung acronym, ay ano yung keyword natin doon class? Kapag attempted, yung binigay ko sa inyo nung start. Yung one word na binigay mismo ng batas natin. Okay, so dapat ha, yung right. Okay, so very good. JB, so that is commences. So meaning, the person just started the execution of execution of crime, meaning he's just started, but then again it will it turned out last not successful. So yan yung tinatawag natin what we call the attempted. So commences the execution of sentence. Then, pag sinabi naman nating frustrated class, okay, ano yung tandaan ninyo pag sinabi nating frustrated? Okay, so what is frustrated? What is that keyword kapag frustrated naman? Okay, so what is frustrated? All present but not produce the felony. Mm-hmm. Okay, so tandaan ninyo class, pag sinabi nating frustrated, ibig sabihin, All acts of execution are present, but the felony was not produced. Again, pag sinabi natin frustrated, all acts of execution are present, but the felony was not produced. Ibig sabihin, hindi naging successful. Okay, yan yung frustrated. How about naman ang consummated? Okay, how about consummated? Bakit si JB lang yung sumasagot, class? Nahiya yung iba? Huwag kayo mahiya, class, ha? So dapat may interaction tayo dito. Okay, how about naman, class, kapag consummated? Okay, how about kapag consummated? Okay, how about consummated? Bakit walang sumasagot? Ay, baka na-delay lang. Ay, na-delay lang pala, siguro. All present, but not produced the felony. Ay, hindi. Yung isa to kanina. Sige, class, sumagot ng lahat. Pag sinabi natin consummated, ano ibig sabihin nun? What is consummated? For another class. Okay, when all elements necessary for its commission are present, all acts of execution are present. Okay, ganito lang kasimple, of course. Pag sinabi nating consummated, all acts of execution are present and the felony was produced or was successful. Ulitin ko, ha? We have the three stages of execution. We have attempted, ibig sabihin, the person commences or just started the commission of the crime but the felony was not produced. Pag sinabi naman natin frustrated, all acts of execution are present, but the felony was not produced. Pag sinabi naman natin consummated, all acts of execution are present, and the felony was successfully produced. So yan yung stages of execution natin. So nakuha? Okay, so I hope it's clear. Then we have the degree of criminal participation of the offender. So we have the principal, accomplice, and accessory. So we have the three degree of criminal participation offender. So we have principal. Pag sinabi natin principal, of course, the author of the crime. Then of course, tatlo yan. So we have the principal of direct participation. Ibig sabihin, the one who directly took part in the execution of sentence. Ibig sabihin, siya mismo yung gumawa. Then we have the principal by indispensable cooperation, ibig sabihin, without which yung participation niya or yung crime would not been successful. Then we have the principal by inducement or induction. Ibig sabihin, the person or yung the one who induced, yung nagsuhol, yung nagbayad, so papasok yan under the principal. Then we have the accomplice. Ang accomplice naman yung kokwa lang. The one who concurs, who confirms, and who approves the commission of the crime. So that is accomplice. And accessories, so tanda nyo lang yung pro con har. Yung pro, that stands for profiting. Yung con, that is concealing. And har is harboring. So that's why we have the pro con har, profiting, concealing, and harboring under the accessory. So again, we have the degree of criminal participation and the stages of execution. Okay, may tanong ba dyan? May tanong? May tanong ba, class? Paki-confirm daw. Okay, so ayan. Sige. Next. Nadi-delay ba yung boses ko, class, sa inyo or okay lang?
Okay lang, boss.
Okay lang. Sige. Okay, next. Okay, dito tayo class naman sa periods. Okay, yung periods, so we have the three equal portion of penalty or three equal periods of penalty. So we have the minimum, medium, and the maximum. Sorry. Okay, so again, we have the minimum, medium, and maximum. So of course, under the divisible penalty, and we have the indivisible penalty. Ang divisible penalty, so we have the maximum, medium, and of course, the minimum. So, under the divisible penalty class, tandaan ninyo, of course, mahahati siya sa tatlo. minimum period, medium period, and maximum period. So, nagbigay tayo kanina ng example ng divisible penalty. Halimbawa, yung reclusion perpetua. Di ba ang reclusion perpetua that is punishable by 20 years plus 1 day to 40 years. So kung titingnan natin under the divisible penalty, ang minimum niya is 20 years, ang medium niya is 30 years, and of course, ang maximum niya is 40 years. So that is the divisible penalty. Pag sinabi naman natin indivisible penalty, those penalties are not, walang nakafix na punishment or walang clear na punishment na binigay ang batas natin. So halimbawa, ang destiero, okay? Then we have the life imprisonment, okay? And of course, we have the death, okay? So again, under the divisible penalty, those penalty are divided into three equal portion of penalty. So minimum, medium, and maximum. So then of course, sa indivisible penalty naman, those penalties are not, walang fixed na punishment or penalty ang binigay ang batas natin. So we have destiero, we have life imprisonment, and of course, we have the death. Okay, so yan yung mga penalties under the indivisible penalty. So again, we have by degrees and of course by period under the penalty to be imposed upon principals in general. Okay, nakuha ba? Nakuha?
Yes, sir.
Okay, nakuha daw. Sige. Bakit parang na yun? Okay, sige. Next. Okay, so meron tayong tinatawag class na condemnation and novation. Okay, sa condemnation and novation, so meaning yan class, a pardon by the victim to the offender. Ibig sabihin, yung pagpatawad ng biktima sa offender natin, yan yung condemnation. Ang novation naman class, okay, ang novation naman, it is a substitution of a new for an old debt. So ibig sabihin, the old debt is extinguished by new one is contracted. Ibig sabihin, nung pinautang ka na ng bago, ibig sabihin daw niyan, yung dati mong utang that is already extinguished, nawala na yon. So that is novation when it comes to civilian class. So ang tanda nyo lang ha, sa condemnation, a pardon by the victim to the offender. Ang novation naman, substitution of a new for an old debt. Okay? The old debt is extinguished by a new one which is contracted. Okay, so yan. The meaning lang yung tandaan nyo dyan, class. Then, of course, we have the total extinction of criminal liability, class. Ibig sabihin, totally, class. Wala na siyang pagkakasala. So, yan yung tinatawag natin na the SAPMA. So, tandaan nyo lang yung acronym kapag hindi ko nakikita yung ano ko. So we have the DSAPMA class, okay? Yung under the total extinction of criminal liability. Totally free na siya. So yung letter D, that stands for the death of convict. Ibig sabihin, of course, kapag namatay yung convict, wala na yan. Wala ng criminal liability. Sino pa yung ipukulong mo? Kasi nga, patay na siya. Then of course, yung letter A, that is amnesty. Okay? So di ba pag sinabi natin amnesty, so that is an act of oblivion by the president. Ibig sabihin, act of forgetfulness. Parang kakalimutan na walang nangyaring krimen. Kasi again, ang amnesty, that is intended for a group of political offenders, meaning yung na-crime na na-commit nila is political in nature. Halimbawa, yung mga kudita and so on. Then we have the letter S, that is the service of sentence. Kapag na-serve niya na yung sentence niya na binigay ng korte or yung penalty na binigay ng korte, so meaning he is now totally extinguish yung criminal liability niya. Wala na. So, of course, laya na siya. Then, of course, we have letter A, absolute pardon. Ang absolute pardon, of course, it is given individually sa tinatawag natin na mga individual kapag na-commit niya ng crime is yung mga regular crimes under the revised penal code. Then we have the prescription of crime class, yung letter P, yung dalawang P class, that is prescription of crime and prescription of penalty. So pag sinabi natin prescription of crime, ibig sabihin, that is the loss or forfeiture of the right of the state to prosecute the crime. Ibig sabihin, or the crime niya na na-commit niya. Ibig sabihin, nawala na ng karapatan ang government or yung state to prosecute the crime or mag-file ng kaso sa kanya. Kasi that is prescription of crime. Pag sinabi natin prescription of penalty naman, class, ibig sabihin, that is the loss rin or the forfeiture of the right of the state to execute the penalty. Okay? Kung ano yung penalty na binigay niya, so wala na silang karapatan kasi na-forfeited na. So again, pag sinabi natin prescription of crime, the loss of the right of the state to prosecute, sorry, the prescription of penalty, that is the loss or the right of the state to execute. Prescription, prosecute, prescription of penalty, execute. So yun yung tandaan ninyo. Then of course, ang another of course yung MA, that stands for marriage of the offended woman on the on case of rape, seduction and others. So yan yung tinatawag natin na the SAPMA, with meaning the person is totally free from the criminal liability. So again, we have the SAPMA, yung D, that stands for death of the convict. Yung A naman, that is amnesty. Yung S, that is sentence, the service of sentence. Ibig sabihin, na-serve nyo na yung sentence niya in jail or in prison cells. Then of course, we have absolute pardon, prescription of crime, prescription of penalty, and the marriage of the offended woman. Okay, so yan yung total extinction of criminal liability of the offender. Okay, totally, wala na talaga, class. Kung meron tayong total extinction of criminal liability, meron din tayong tinatawag ngayon, what if yung case ng rape, marami ang ng rape at isa lang ang pinakasal, binaba, ma-prosecute yung iba. Yes, of course. Kapag maraming ng rape class, kapag halimbawa tatlo or apat yung ng rape sa kanya, kung sino lang yung wait lang. Ah, hindi. Mamaya ko na lang i-ano to para hindi tayo erase muna 'yon. So mamaya na natin. So we have the partial extinction of criminal liability. So again, sa partial extinction of criminal liability, tandaan ninyo, ibig sabihin, he is not totally free. Okay? He is not totally free. So meaning, meron pa rin siyang kaakibat or meron pa rin siyang rules and regulations na dapat sundin. Pag nagkamali siya, class, tandaan ninyo, under the partial, he will serve the unexpired portion of his or her sentence. Okay, so tandaan ninyo, so yan yung partial extinction of criminal liability. So we have 2PRC2. Ang 2P, that stands for probation. Then of course, another P, we have parole. Yung R naman, that stands for reprieve. Then yung C, that stands for commutation of sentence. And of course, yung another C, that is conditional pardon. So isahin natin. Wait lang ah. Inom muna ako ng tubig. Okay. Sige. Pag sinabi natin probation class, of course, instead of serving the sentence in prison, isi-serve niya ngayon sa community kung saan siya nanggaling. So that's why ang probation, that is also known as judicial clemency, kasi ang nagbibigay niyan, class, is the court. So that is probation. Then pag sinabi naman natin parole, of course, before niya ma-serve yung maximum indeterminate sentence or yung sentence sa class, pwede siya magranta ng parole. Ibig sabihin, because of his good behavior, yung one-third. Kapag na-serve niya na yung one-third of his indeterminate sentence, so pwede siyang mabigyan ng tinatawag natin na parole. Then, of course, we have the reprieve. Okay, so pag sinabi natin reprieve, that is the temporary suspension of sentence or the temporary stay of sentence. Ibig sabihin, ipagpaliban muna yung pag-execute ng death penalty. Kasi nga, ang reprieve that is intended or that is applicable to the death penalty. Then we have the commutation of sentence. Okay, ang commutation of sentence last. Tandaan ninyo, pag sinabi natin commutation of sentence, it has an effect na ma-reduce from a longer sentence to a shorter one under the commutation of sentence. Then, of course, we have the conditional pardon. Sa conditional pardon, of course, kaibahan yan or kabaliktaran yan ni absolute pardon. Ang conditional pardon, there are a set of conditions attached to its granting. Meaning, may susundin pa rin siya ng mga rules and regulations ng Boards of Pardons and Parole. Kapag hindi niya or nalabag niya yon, he will serve the expired portion of his sentence before siya nagrantan ng tinatawag natin na parole or conditional pardon rather. Okay, so again, sa the partial extinction of criminal liability, so we have the 2PRC2, probation, parole, reprieve, commutation of sentence, and conditional pardon. Okay, so we have the civil liability class. So we have the two classes of civil liability. We have the social injury and the personal injury. Ang social injury, ibig sabihin, sorry, okay, yung mga damages or yung na-cause mo sa community or sa society. Ang personal injury naman, of course, yung sa victim mismo. Okay, so sa pamilya ng victim, halimbawa, yung asawa niya, kasi nga pinatay mo yung husband niya, of course, nawalan siya ng kapartner. So, babayaran yung class. Ipocompute lahat yun. So, yun yung civil liability. Kaya ang civil liability minsan umaabot ng ilang milyon. Kasi hindi lang nawalan yung nawalan ng husband, yung mga anak. Ipocompute yun. Kapag nawalan ng lahat na yan. So, personal, lahat ng stage, i-compute yung tinatawag natin. Yes, ipapasa natin to. Lahat ng videos natin class na sa Telegram ang ating recorded na mga lecture. So yan yung personal injury at social injury. So what are included in civil liability? So of course, we have indemnification. Ibig sabihin, that is a payment of the damages. Babayaran mo kung ano yung presyo ng mga bagay na kinuha mo, halimbawa sa crime of theft. So, yan yung indemnification. Ang restitution naman, isa sa uli mo or you must return the things na nakuha mo. So, that is restitution. Ang reparation naman, that is you must repair or you must restore yung bagay na kinuha mo. Halimbawa, nasira mo yung laptop na kinuha mo. So, dapat ipaayos mo yon. So, that is reparation. You must repair and you return the things or yung articles na yon. Okay, so dito tayo class, i-explain natin what is destiero under Article 87. So pag sinabi natin destiero, any person sentenced to destiero shall not be permitted to enter the place or places designated in the sentence. Again, they are not allowed to enter the place designated or specified, nor within the radius therein specified. Sorry, tandaan niyo. Okay, shall not be more than 250 and not less than 25 kilometer radius from the place designated. Tandaan niyo ang destiero, not more than 250 kilometer radius or not less than 25 kilometers from the place designated. Ang destiero class, it is considered as the principal penalty, correctional and divisible penalty. Then of course, ang jurisdiction yan over sa crime or yung penalty na destiero, yan yung tinatawag natin na Municipal Trial Court or the MTC. Then entering the prohibited area is what we call the evasion of service of sentence. Again, in the crime of destiero or in the penalty of destiero class, kapag hindi mo nasunod yan, yung tinatawag natin na 25 or 250 kilometer radius or not less than 25 kilometer radius from the place designated or yung pinangyarihan ng krimen, you will be charged as yung crime na nakomit mo is evasion of service of sentence. Okay? So, yung destiero, parang hindi yan serious penalty kasi hindi naman talaga penalty yan. Pero once na nalabag mo yan class, you will be charged or you will be punished or you will be pwede kang file ng kaso na evasion of the service of sentence. Nakuha ba? Nakuha? Paki ano nga, paki ano class, paki confirm ko na
Yes,
kung ano
sir.
yung
Nakuha po.
destino. Okay, of course, ang destino ha,
Yes,
automatic
sir.
pilihan sa crime na concubinage doon sa concubine sa kabit. Kapag once yung husband ma-convict sa crime na concubinage, then of course, ang destino niyan, ano yan, papasok yan sa death under exceptional circumstances, yung napatay mo yung husband mo or wife mo, kapag you're caught in the act, having sexual intercourse with another man or woman, so papasok yan, or ang ibibigay na penalty ng sa'yo is destiero. Okay? Parang ilalayo ka lang sa lugar kung saan nangyari yung krimen. Okay? So, yan. Then, of course, we have the prescription of crimes and prescription of penalties. I-explain natin yan. So, dito tayo ngayon sa prescription of crimes. Under the prescription of crimes class, tandaan nyo lang na keyword dyan, of course, yung prosecute. So, it is the forfeiture or the loss of the right of the state to prosecute. Ibig sabihin, hindi ka na pwedeng mag-file ng kaso class. The offender after the lapse of a certain crime. So, that's why, ano yung tinatawag natin na 12-18-36 class? What if, sir, kung dinadalaw niya yung namatay na kamag-anak, tapos pumasok siya sa place designated, sir? Okay. So, ang destiero naman, class, hindi naman na, ano yan, so, sundin niya talaga dapat yung tinatawag natin na nakasaad sa ano niya. As long as hindi siya mahuli na ganun yung ginawa niya, na dinalaw niya yung kamag-anak na pasok doon sa nakatalaga na kilometer radius, wala namang mangyayari. Okay? So, dapat hindi lang talaga siya magpapahuli na malapit siya doon sa pinangyarihan ng place, pinangyarihan ng krimen. Okay? Or yung place designated. So, again, dito class sa prescription crimes, mawawala yung karapatan ng state or ng government to prosecute. Ibig sabihin, mag-file ng kaso after the lapse of a certain crimes or certain times rather yan. Pag sinabi natin 12-18-36, yun yung reglementary period. Ibig sabihin, within the time, dapat ma-filean mo na ng kaso yung tao na yan. Kasi kapag hindi, i-dismiss or walang mangyayaring filing of cases or walang mangyayaring trial and hearing. Yan yung tinatawag natin na forfeiture or the prescription of crime. It will commence to run or it will be started on the time where the crime is discovered by the authorities and their agents. So yan yung tinatawag natin na prescription of crimes. Then it will be interrupted class by filing of complaint or information. Of course, kapag na-file ng information or complaint, then may karapatan na yung government to prosecute yung offender natin. Okay. So ang prescription of crimes ng what we call the death, repression perpetua, and repression 20, repression temporal is 20 years. Ang mga afflictive penalties naman, 15. Ang correctional penalties naman, 10 years. And the crime of libel naman, 1 year. Ang offenses of oral defamation and slander by deed, 6 months yan. Ang light offenses, 2 months. Of course, ang mga fines, kapag yung fines is afflictive, 15 years. Kapag fine is correctional, 10 years. Kapag fine is a light, 2 months lang. Okay, paki-screenshot ninyo class, yung prescription of crimes. Paki-memorize to ha. Oh, sorry. Paki-familiarize lang. Ito. Okay, i-familiarize nyo to. Kasi halimbawa, pag sinabi nila sa board exam, what is the prescription of crime? Or what is the prescription of crime sa crime or of offenses or of oral defamation and slander by deed. So, dapat yung isagot nyo doon, 6 months. So, ganun. Na-screenshot na? Na-screenshot na class? Paki ano daw?
Yes po.
Okay, sige. Next. Okay, so then of course we have the prescription of penalties. Or yung tinatawag natin na forfeiture or the loss of the right of the government class to execute naman. Okay, to execute naman yung final sentence or final judgment after the lapse of a certain time. So it will start that class or magsa-start yan kapag the culprit or yung ano natin, evaded the service of his sentence. Ibig sabihin, he evade. Tumakas siya. So yan yung tinatawag natin na prescription of penalties. Then of course, it will be interrupted. Okay? Ibig sabihin, may karapatan na yung government or state natin to execute the final judgment or final sentence sa convict natin kapag, letter A, kapag yung tao na yon, he gives himself up, okay, sa authorities, be captured, nahuli siya, go to the foreign country which we have no extradition treaty, commits another crime before the expiration of periods of prescription. So yun yung maiinterap yan. Then of course, ang sa death and reclusion perpetua, that yung prescription of penalty niya class is 20 years. Ang other afflictive penalties naman, 15 years yan. Ang correctional penalties naman, 10 years, except of course yung arresto mayor, prescribed in 5 years. And of course, yung light penalties, 1 year naman yan. Okay, so isulat nyo yan lahat sa notes ninyo. Ha? Walang patulog-tulog. Dapat double time. So ang focus ninyo dyan, yung mga acronym, yung mga keywords rather, execute. Okay, kapag commence to run, culprit, evade the sentence. Kapag sa prescription of crime natin, kailan magra-run by the filing, by the discovery of the authorities. Or yun yung tinatawag natin na prescription of crime and prescription of penalties. Okay, screenshot niyo class. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, nakuha na ba? Ay na ano na class, na screenshot na. Okay. Sige. Yes, yeah. Okay, so dito tayo sa we have the good conduct time allowance for loyalty. Okay, so of course ang good conduct time allowance or GCTA, so yan yung binibigay ang privileges kapag of course from your good conduct, yung ginawa mo yun nasa loob. Ibig sabihin, may disiplina ka doon sa loob. So, na-explain na natin actually ito sa correction. So, in the first 2 years, 20 days yung deduction sa'yo. Third to fifth year naman, 23 days. Ang following years and until 10th year, 25 days. Kapag 11th and successive years, then 30 years, ay 30 days rather. Then, of course, before ka i-release sa community that is intended for study, teaching, or mentoring. So, yan yung good conduct time allowance. So, na-explain na rin natin to class sa correction. So, doon natin na-explain in detail. Okay. Then, of course, kapag may good conduct time allowance, we also have the special time allowance for loyalty or gestol na tinatawag natin. We have the 1/5 deduction of sentence and of course, we have the 2/5 deduction of sentence. Ang 1/5 class, kapag during the existence of calamities, hindi talaga siya, during the existence of calamities class, after the passing of calamities rather, then nasabi ni President, okay, pwede na kayong bumalik kasi wala nang pagbaha, wala nang paglindol. Then within the 48 hours, then he surrender himself, okay? He surrender himself or herself. Then bumalik siya doon sa kulungan, he will be entitled to the 1/5 deduction of his sentence. Kapag during the existence of ano naman class of calamities or insurgencies na hindi talaga siya umalis doon sa loob ng kulungan or lumabas siya sa kulungan pero hindi siya nakalabas class sa area of responsibility. Ibig sabihin doon lang siya sa loob. Hindi siya nakalabas sa gate. So meaning he will be credited or he will, yung sentence niya class meron siyang 2/5 deduction of his sentence. Take note class, ang special time allowance for loyalty, it shall only be applied to any prisoner whether it is undergoing preventive imprisonment, na-discuss na natin kanina what is preventive imprisonment, or already convicted, or yung service serving sentence already. Then, sino yung nag-grant class ng good conduct time allowance? Of course, sa BUCOR, si Director. Sa BGMP naman, ang nag-grant is si Chief BGMP. Then of course, sa warden naman, ang warden naman kapag sa provincial, district, municipal, or city jail. Then kapag yung good and special time allowance for loyalty will be granted, such allowance, once granted, shall not be revoked. Okay, so yan yung special time allowance for loyalty. Again, 1/5 deduction kapag after 48 hours or after the president announce the passing away of the calamities or any catastrophes, then you surrender yourself or himself in the authorities o bumalik siya doon sa kulungan, he will be credited with 1/5 deduction. Kapag hindi siya umalis, doon during the existence of calamities, then he will be deducted of two-fifths deduction of his or her sentence. Okay. So, kailan ma-extinct class? Ibig sabihin, totally talaga, wala ka ng babayaran or extinction of civil liability. So, meron tayong tinatawag na PC3, no? PC, C3, NO. Okay. So, ang payment or performance, of course, kapag binayaran mo, syempre, wala ka ng utang or wala ka ng civil liability. Condonation or remission of debt. Di ba, na-explain natin kanina yung condonation. Ibig sabihin, meron tayong napalitan ng bagong utang, yung dating utang. So, that is condonation. Then, confession or merger of the rights of the creditor and the debtor. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, na nag-merge sila. Okay? May pinagkasunduan. Compensation. I-compensate. Babayaran. Okay? Nang tama. Then, of course, novation or yung pardon, yung pagpatawad ng victim sa offender kapag sa civil yan. And, of course, other causes. So, yun yung mga extinction of civil liability class. PC, C3, NO. Payment of performance or performance, condonation or remission of debt, confession or merger of the rights of the creditor and debtor, compensation, novation, and other causes. So yan yung mga extinction of civil liability. Okay, nakuha ba? Yan yung extinction of civil liability. Nakuha, class? Nakuha? Okay, sige. Good. Okay, so next tayo. Ah, okay. So doon pala nag-end class ang ating book 1 kasi yung AK or KA that is already book 2 na. Okay. So ayan, so diyan nag-end yung ating ano kanina. May question kanina dito class before tayo mag-end. Okay, kapag marami daw silang offender, then yung nagkataon na isa lang yung pinakasalan ng na taong yung babaeng na rape. So ano yung mangyayari sa iba? Okay, of course class makukulong sila. Yung isa lang yung magiging acquitted kasi marriage of the acquitted woman, it is a total extinction of the criminal liability of the offender. The remaining offenders class, yan yung tinatawag natin, hindi sila mapawalang sala kasi isa lang yung ano niya. Pero may narinig ako sa ibang explanation, iba-iba kasi yung explanation nila diyan. Ano daw, lahat daw, pero hindi ka sa yung kung sino lang yung gi-pardon ng biktima, kung sino yung pinakasalan niya, hindi niya naman pwedeng pakasalan lahat, di ba? Okay? So pangit naman, so yung apat hindi pwede. So kung sino yung pinardon niya class, yun yung magiging or siya yung ma-acquit. Okay, wala na. So kasi nga of course husband and wife na sila. So yun yung book 1 natin class. So I hope